Welcome you again to an exciting program today. I can't believe that I know everybody in this circle, and you will know them momentarily, to the Spiritual Revival Hour, and we'll be going around the circle, and we have a new guest who was on last week, a new person who is a part of our circle, who many of you, if not all of you, who are watching and or listening. No, to my left is Bishop Billy Gilmore.
Billy.
Yes.
It's a new one.
And so he has two guests that have a very special program and, dare I say, ministry happening on the east side of Wilmington, one of our more critical and powerful communities historically in the city of Wilmington. And so I'm going to turn it over to Bishop Wilmore, and he will introduce the other guests, and we'll have a conversation about that during this segment. And later on in this segment, we'll have a brief conversation about voter turnout and early voting and souls to the polls. So, Bishop Wilmore, would you lead us?
Thank you, Dr. Greer. I appreciate you, and I appreciate being here, and it's exciting to be a part of this team and what we're trying to do in our community. My guests today are two people that really don't need a lot of introduction. One of them, Wilmington's first African-American mayor, someone that I was proud to be his press secretary for, Mayor James Sills, and a very dear friend of many old days ago, fellow by the name of Gary Hutt. And so, gentlemen, welcome. And first, I gotta start off real briefly and say happy belated 91st birthday to Jim Sills.
Oh, boy, that was nice of you to mention that.
Not just birthday, but the year.
Yeah. Well, we were going to get a cake and have a young lady jump out of it, but that would not be appropriate for this. We'll do that on another thing. But listen, there is an exciting venture going on in the east side of Wilmington, the African American Heritage Institute. This is something that is so exciting. It's not brand new, but it is really taking off now, and there's some very special things about to happen. Mayor, tell us what it's about and where we are and what's going to happen.
Well, I like the name Billy. maybe we ought to try to say what it's not. The African American Heritage Institute is a program which specializes in teaching African-American history and educating people about the African-American experience. It is not a nonprofit that provides services. We have a lot of those in Wilmington. Mm-hmm. It's a program which plans to focus and specialize on programs that educate people about the Black experience, mm-hmm. which teaches about the Black experience. Mm-hmm. We've been in existence about 13 years. Gary is going to talk a little bit about the programs, a little bit about the funding. You need to know, though, that we've got a long way to go. Mm. We need to help the community mm-hmm. to feel some sense of ownership mm-hmm. of our program and to begin to see the need to try to help it be more than what it is.
Excellent.
To develop programs which people need to know about relative to history. And need a little bit, need to talk a little bit about James Weldon Johnson, mm-hmm. who authored the Negro Anthem, who advocated initially Black history. Mm-hmm. It was James Weldon Johnson who said many times, the problem that we are experiencing within the Black community is not having enough knowledge, enough appreciation of the Black history in this country.
Absolutely.
And we need to give more attention mm-hmm. to helping young people yes. to know about that history.
And Gary, I know that this organization, the mission is community empowerment and knowledge. You folks are going to literally transform and transmogrify that part of Wilmington and bring into fruition the knowledge that a lot of people of a younger generation know nothing about.
Well, thank you for saying that, because that's critically important, especially now. You know, we're living in a time where there's a real serious attempt to ignore the contributions of African Americans, not only in the city of Wilmington, but mm-hmm. around the country. Mm-hmm. And this country was built largely on the backs and labor, and not just the labor and the backs, but on the intellect of African Americans and their contributions.
Our forebears.
Absolutely. And it's critically important that not only our young people become aware and are knowledgeable about our contributions, but mm-hmm. the entire community. White folks need to understand Black history as well as Black folks. A lot of folks don't know our contribution, mm-hmm. The contributions that we've made, certainly not nationally, but certainly in Wilmington. And one of the things, and in Delaware. And it's a rich history, it's an interesting history. And I think the more we understand that history, the better we understand each other.
Yeah.
And it changes how we relate to each other today.
Now, obviously, we're not going to be able to tell this whole story in this short segment, so we're going to make sure you guys are coming back a little bit later on. But
no, I'm going to tell the whole thing right now.
But is anything worthwhile doing takes money? This is taking a lot of money. And I got to ask you this question. Where are you going to get the money to do this?
Well, the fact is that that it's not easy to raise that kind of money. And the kind of project that we're working on takes a lot of money. We have, Mayor Sills kind of alluded to our origins, but from the beginning, we've looked at properties on the east side. And our primary property was the old L.I. Kidd building at 11th and Clifford Brown mm-hmm. Walk mm-hmm. and three or four adjacent parcels to that property. Initially, our deal with the city was that those properties would be transferred to us for the purpose of building this institute. somewhere along the line, the city said, well, look, we want to help you, but you got to show us that you can do some things yourself. So there's some benchmarks that we had to hit along the way. And the first benchmark was that we had to raise $1.2 million.
Wow.
And we've done that. And we've done that with support from the state, from philanthropic organizations like the Welfare Foundation. We've done that with support from our community. IMAC has been right there for us. They've contributed. Individuals in our community have made contributions. So that $1.2 million that we raised up to this point is a collection of a effort by a whole lot of different people. And moving forward, we're going to need more of the same.
Mayor Sills, during your administration, I recall that empowerment, particularly in the African-American community, was real important to you. Is this effort any easier for this organization because it has a Jim Sills in place, or where are your challenges?
Well, Gary has talked about the support we've gotten from governmental agencies. Whether we can keep that support, sustain that support, will depend heavily on getting more support from the black community.
Churches and all?
Churches and all. We need to help the black community to see the value of supporting this organization as one of its own. Mm. And we need to help the black community to see the need to adopt our organization and provide sustained support beyond what we've gotten initially from the local government. And that's a tough challenge for us. We don't have as a racial group, history of supporting
each other.
Absolutely.
African American Heritage Centers, we provide some support to museum type groups, but we don't have a history of supporting groups that teach history and teach young people to be identified with that history.
Dr. Greer, you say what on that?
No, I just want to raise a question because how important what you said is, both in terms of the funds that are needed and the connection with the African American community. Can you share, one of you, with our watching or listening audience, where they can find information to make the connection, whether by information or support? Is there a website? Could you share that with?
There is a website, and it's called the Delaware African American Heritage Institute.
Website. Say it again.
Delaware African American Heritage Institute. They can just Google that and they can find our webpage. And there's a lot of information out there about where we've been, where we are, and where we'd like to go. And I can't emphasize enough Mayor Sills' point. The level of support, whether state government support or local government support or any governmental support or federal government support, the level of support from philanthropic nonprofits is going to be a function of how much support we have from the community.
Now, from concept to construction, what's the time frame? When are we going to see some ground possibly broken to get us started on this?
Well, again, that's another good question. It's going to be in phases. The very first phase, we hope, would begin early next year. And there's a property next door to the L.I. Kidd building. Mm-hmm. There's a single-family home. We've raised the money to renovate that. As soon as the city, we get through the final phases of negotiation with the city of Wilmington, we hope to take ownership of those properties. And the very first phase will be the renovation of that residential property next to the L.I. Kidd, where we will actually start generating some of our programming that would be ultimately transferred over to the bigger building.
City government is really on board with all of this? What do we need to do?
City government is on board with this. The mayor's office as well as city council.
We had a conversation before we came in to the studio about when was this going to happen. Mm-hmm. And I think the response was from one of you, well, we're closer than we've ever been.
And that's
because
true.
Because I've been hearing about this. Mm-hmm. Not that my ear is always to the rail, but I've been hearing about this project, excited about the project, and actually did some early conversations with some of the people on the board about the project. So I'm excited, but I'm also excited that we have the kind of minds and history
That's
and
right.
Intellect and commitment to this, I say ministry, that we have here, Gary Hutt and Mayor Sills. And unfortunately, we have to move forward with this program. So we're going to call you folks back, I'm sure, sooner than later to give us more details. And you'll be a part of that as well, Bishop. But I need
Billy.
Billy, yes, I like that. So the next segment that you folks will be seeing will be talking about the upcoming elections. You know that Spiritual Revival Hour has been a significant part of keeping before the people the dates and the places of early registration, and that will be coming up. And so the next segment will be talking about the upcoming election and the importance of the faith community involvement in our future, not only in Wilmington and Delaware, but in this country. So we thank all of you for sharing your gifts and your skills and your mind and your vision for the city. I want to say quickly, though I forgot, the East Side, it's important for that to be on the East Side. The East Side has significant history. In black history in the city of Wilmington and the state of Delaware. So we'll see you in a few moments, and thank you for sharing with us.
Thank you.
Yeah. watching Everyone on Medicare. New Medicare Advantage plans are now available. Did you know that you may be eligible for additional Medicare-approved benefits that include free eyeglasses, free hearing aids, free meal delivery, free rides to medical appointments, and much more? The Medicare Benefits Hotline is now open. Just call the toll-free number on your screen now to see if you qualify for additional Medicare benefits and make sure you're getting all the benefits you deserve. Just call 800-520-3805 now. In addition to dental, vision, hearing, and prescription drug coverage, you may also qualify for $0 monthly premiums, $0 deductibles, and no copays. Just call the toll-free number on your screen now to see if you're eligible for additional Medicare benefits that may include free eyeglasses, free hearing aids, free meal delivery, free rides to medical appointments, and much more. The call and Medicare benefits review are absolutely free. There's no obligation to enroll. Just call 800-520-3805 to see if you qualify.
They come to make you strong. Floating on the sea of trouble. Sorrow falling like rain from the sky. Trotting through life's murky waters. Trials form the tears in your eyes. Don't. I'm telling you, there's a blessing on the other side of you.
Over the years, we've met so many nice people and good customers. I call them my friends. Most of my furniture is contemporary. Good style, good quality. My son does all the buying. We have the lowest prices around. We try to cater to what the area wants. We have a wonderful delivery service, probably better than anybody in the city. We've been here 34 years. Just come in and say hi.
Oh, closer to voting season, let us remind you all that this is an important election which will affect the lives of minorities for years to come. So it is imperative that if you are of age and qualified to vote, you must do so and encourage others to do the same. The only thing that you have equal to the president is your vote. And remember that when you vote, vote for the person and not the party. For further information, call 302-287-4413.
Help me, help me, help me, help me, help me.
I'm Shanae Darby, inviting you to consider what better way to celebrate Black History Month than to support a legend of over 50 plus years of dedicated, committed services to the community. Dr. Benjamin Twinbee Brown and Community Communications Corporations introduce internet cable to Wilmington and Newcastle County. It is also the creator of Lease Access TV programming you now enjoy here on Channel 28. It is the godfather of the annual Thanksgiving, Christmas dinner, and turkey giveaways to the community for over 40 years. One of the founding members of the Minister's Action Councils, known as IMAC, conducted the largest successful voter education and registration drive ever in our county. For over 42 years, conducted studio and on-site hands-on video workshops for youth and adults. Created the longest airing local cable TV programming and many more broadcasting entities. He is still active and productive to this day. Oh, what a legacy. If you would like to support Dr. Benjamin Twinbee Brown and Community Communications Corporation, contact us at 302-287-4413. If your call is not answered, please leave a clear message carefully stating your name, an email address, and detailing information will be emailed to you promptly.
Welcome back to another conversation on this week's edition of the Spiritual Revival Hour. The founder and regular host sitting across from me has joined us, and that's in the person of the Reverend Twinbee Brown, who's been doing this for a number of decades. And so we are honored for you to be a part of this conversation. And of course, Bishop Wilmore to my left, to your right, my left. And what we're talking about this particular few moments has to do with something extremely important for the year 2022 in Wilmington, in Delaware, and across the country. And we're not gonna politicize the conversation. What we're talking about is responsible citizens who are responsible to vote. Mm. The opportunities to vote are numerous. There is early voting. It's called voting before Election Day. And those dates are October
20th. 15th
is the register. Last day to register.
Right.
Right?
That's correct.
But early voting starts the 28th of October. Yeah. And goes through the 6th of November. We will be repeating that over and over so you don't forget it. So the importance of voting, the fact that it's right upon us, and the dynamics of that it will create, whichever way, whatever election goes, I'm going to turn it over to Bishop Wilmore to have that initial statement about where we've been, where we are, and where we need to be going as a faith community as
Thank
it relates
you. Thank
to participation
you.
In the process.
Thank you, Dr. Greer. In the last segment, you called me Billy, and that's okay. Just to not to be confused with Bishop Billy Lane, a little shout out.
Yeah,
owe me
sorry
some money.
About that.
He'll owe me some money for that little free commercial there. Good to be here, as always. I'm excited to be a part of the Spiritual Revival Hour family.
Yes.
Thank you for welcoming me, Dr. Brown. Thank you, as always, for being a mentor and so much a part of my life. Ladies and gentlemen, this is, I believe, perhaps the most important election that you will ever decide at the polls. First of all of our state elected officials are up for re-election. Many of you often complain about him or her not doing their job or not doing enough, and this is your opportunity to make change, to go to the polls, register to vote. People died that you might have an opportunity to decide what's happening. And there's a lot happening in America right now. And a lot of it's going to begin right on the state level. I'm remembering Dr. Greer in the 70s, as we talk about the involvement of the faith community. There was an interview, a printed interview, entitled, "Sometimes Just Us." You were part of that. You had some very profound and prolific things to say of what your views about the involvement of the faith community. Share some of that with us now and how important it is for the churches to get involved.
Well, I didn't know you were going to toss it back to me, but that interview was some time ago. But my practice has always been, as a faith leader in any community where I happen to be pastoring or leading, is for us, African Americans, people of color, to be involved with that which provides for our future. Mm. We can't, my friends, be involved just by sitting in our pews or worshiping in our sanctuary or shouting, "Thank you, Jesus," on Sunday morning. We do that, and we need to do that, because what we're going through week after week, we need to be doing that on Sunday. Probably ought to be doing it in the middle of the week as well.
Absolutely.
But let me say, this is what drives me to be out in the community, not just voting. Those of you who know the Bible, I'm not going to test these two theologians here. You'll recall that there were only a handful of times that Jesus was found in the temple.
Yes.
5 or 6 times. Most of those times he was in trouble.
Absolutely.
Either he created or somebody else. My point is this. Jesus, our Redeemer in the faith communities that we're a part of, did his work, died, was crucified, and rose again. But his intention was not for us to just worship him on Sunday morning or worship God, but to be in the hoods that he was in, traveling and the walking and riding on donkeys and you know, the miracles. Much of what Jesus did was in the hood, not in the temple.
And so
we need to be involved so that our future can be more productive and proactive for us.
And it occurs to me that the whole title, Souls to the polls,
yes,
is logical. Dr. Brown, you have worked tirelessly in the community. This is not the first time you've been in this rodeo of trying to get people registered to vote. You've been involved in that for how long, and how's it going now with Souls to the Polls?
Well, it's so important now because of the attitude and the disposition of people who benefit from good elected officials and good people being in office have relaxed so. Until they have lost the value of what their parents and co-parents and other people have suffered and died for. So we want to, here on Spiritual Revival, I'll go back and remind people that there were many sacrifices were paid for them to have the right to register and vote. People take that for granted, that other people voting is going to help them. They don't look at the fact that the only thing
the only thing that they have that's equal to the President of the United States is that one vote.
Mm-hmm.
That's how important that vote is. So what we have done over the years here, spiritual revival, how we've had campaigns and drives and all that, but what we have done here in electing the first mayor that was on the first set, we had a countywide voter registration extra drive that I understand is on record. It's the largest ever been in the city or the county. And different people have gotten in office because of this platform here. So we want to continue to use this platform, which all help, to remind people of how important it is to be identified by registering and vote.
Yeah, and I must tell you folks watching, this is very important because something has recently changed. House Bill 25 made it possible for people to go and register to vote and vote all the way up to Election Day. You could register to vote right on Election Day and vote the same day. The Delaware State Supreme Court has ruled that unconstitutional. So that's back now to where we were. You have only a few days to register.
Yes.
Pre-register. October the 15th is the deadline. If you want to vote in the November general election, you got to get it done now.
Yeah.
What's at stake? Dr. Greer, what's at stake now?
Let me preface that by saying that several states and other communities, political communities, have moved to make it more difficult for people to vote. And as our history would reflect, that difficulty is now placed more on people of color than anyone else. So what we need to say is don't let what others create as barriers keep you from registering and from voting.
Mm.
There are faith communities, and then there's something you need to share about. We'll get to that in a minute about the thing you talked about about promoting it some other way. You can share that at the end. But we need to get people to the polls. If you have a car and you're driving to a poll, and you got a neighbor who you think might benefit from you asking, hey, you want to go vote? Do that. And of course, that's the other thing. We're not as close to our neighbors as we used to
be. Right.
So that's part of what we need to do in our communities. It's extremely important. And you're a pastor, so you need, I know we can't politicize it from the pulpit. We can't tell people who to vote for, but we can encourage them to go out and vote. And some churches have vehicles that they can offer as transportation.
You know, we
from
are
point A to point B.
As the church, I speak and make this a blanket statement. The church is one of the most powerful voices in the world.
Yes.
We see more people, even with COVID and such, and return of folk. We see more people. Our message is available to so many people, and I think it's important. And I'm challenging my pastor friends to empower your people to go register to vote. You got a little few days, but get them out there. Get your vans. Get them out there. Get them to the polls when they open to make sure. And if you don't like somebody that's in the office or not doing the job for you, then you know what you need to do.
Now that's important for people to remember, because it was a little concerned and mixed up about the cutoff date for registering, the 15th of October.
They just changed this last Friday.
Yeah.
Yep.
Okay, so the 15th of October, we have a campaign drive here on that spiritual revival hour, Souls to the Polls, and early voting. Early voting starts on the 28th of this month, the 28th of this month to the 6th of November. What that means, that you can go and register and vote. Remember, registering cut off at the 15th of the month, but that does not stop you from voting. You can vote up until the 6th of November.
Right.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Now, Wilmington have a very comfortable place that's set up in Wilmington. For those of you, they have polling places all over the county, but the most convenient one for you, if you live in the city of Wilmington, is at the waterfront on the same corner of the Chase Center, and everybody know where the Chase Center is. That will be
on Justice Street.
Now on Sunday, yeah, there are two Sundays involved between the 28th of this month
and
November the 6th. There are two Sundays there. And doing that on the Sunday, Souls to the Poll, you can vote from 7 a.m. to 7 p.m. on Sunday. Now, the other days have different dates to open and close, but on Sunday, both of those Sundays, you can leave church or on your way to church or to grocery shopping or whatever from 7 a.m. to 7 p.m. on Sunday. Souls to the Poll. All right.
And you said in the last time we were on together that maybe the Holy Ghost will get on you and
yeah, maybe the Holy Ghost will direct you to the polling place.
But listen, let me just say this to folks who still have questions about, listen, when can I do this? When can I do that? Go to the website for the Department of Elections, www, whatever it is, you'll Google it, Google will touch you anywhere. Go to the Department of Elections website and all that new information, including what just happened to change HP 25, is now on the site right now, and you can figure it all out.
One of the things that we did during over the years and registering and voting, for those people who don't have computers, a lot of people don't have cable and all that, we're going to try to arrange. We had to put a sound truck out on the street for those people that
that's old school.
Okay, old school, but it touched those people who never have computers and all that. So we're working on that now, and we think we're going to have that worked out also.
I need to say, clarify something about early voting. There are several places where that takes place. Right. It may not be your regular voting place.
That's
so
right.
Make sure you go on the website that was just
right.
referred to find that. Don't be confused, because that's what they want you to do. They, mm-hmm. they want to keep us confused. But before we close, you're the guru here, Dr. Brown. Is there anything you need to say before we close about the importance of voting this year?
Well, it's so important because of there are certain things going on with elected officials. A lot of people don't understand. Yeah. And in the olden days, you know, we didn't have the TV and computers and all that. Yeah. We had ward leaders.
Right.
Ward leaders
yeah.
would go around
yeah.
in the community. And I
yeah.
used to,
yeah.
I got in trouble with my grandmother about that. The ward leader would go around and say, we're going with such and such a person. They didn't even worry about who that was.
Right.
When they went
right.
in the poll booth and vote for them. So
right.
it's important for you to study and,
yes.
and find out who you're really voting for. Remember now, you can be a big shot here. You don't have but one vote. The President of the United States is not past you on this, because the President don't have but one vote also.
That's right, right. Well, thank you for all you continue to do for our community. Almost called you Bishop Brown, Dr.
He
Brown.
He is Bishop.
We're going to continue to have these conversations
Benny Brown.
Until the election,
yes.
So that you'll be reminded week after
Absolutely.
Week. And so we hope that you will take this to heart. If you have any questions, I'm sure there'll be numbers popping up on the screen that
yes.
you can call. And we'll be back again next Sunday for another edition
of
Spiritual
only
Revival Hour.
Not only
yeah.
for those people, let's remind people that the people living in Wilmington can go down to the water.
The people living, that's correct.
But
yeah.
on the screen,
yeah.
you will see different other locations, different times that
correct.
The polling places are open. So take the information down if you live anywhere else in the county.
And thank you, Bishop Wilmore, for
thank
joining
you.
Us today.
Always.
And we'll see you, apparently,
I'll be around.
In the future.
As a Spinner said, I'll
and
be around.
See, we'll see the rest of you next Sunday.
It keeps setting my soul on fire.
Whatever it is,
whatever it is,
whatever it is,
whatever it is, it won't let me.
say I'm acting strange. Makes me wanna run on in Jesus' name. It makes me love all my enemies, yes it does.
And it makes me love all my friends. And it won't let me be ashamed to tell the world I've been born again.
Makes me do right when I